Oh, welcome boys. The previous class we have seen the visualization of the results. Today I am going to show you again some drawings, saving of the formats, importing them into the MOPAC and then visualization of the results. So this session should be very interesting because I am going to show you the electrons. We have been drawing in the class. The electrons like that. So okay, let me share the screen. So visualization of the result, visualization of the results, and this will have molecular descriptors. The molecular descriptors means, I told you, ionization potential and electron affinity. Highest occupied molecular orbital, lowest unoccupied molecular orbital, dipole moment, etc. Okay, and here you can see the orbitals directly. So this will give you an idea about how successful the quantum chemistry and the packages. And also, I'm going to tell you about a new software which is called as General Atomic and Molecular Structure System. It is not GAMES, it is called as GAMES. What has happened over the period is GAMES has been converted into PC GAMES by a Russian scientist, and it has been brought in the form of a software called as a Firefly. Firefly, this is a free software. This is a free software. So I have used this on a lot of occasions, and particularly it is able to calculate molecular electrostatic potential. Okay, and then natural bond order is called as the NBO. NBO is, you know, it calculates charges. It calculates charges based on electron population. Electron population. Whereas you have Mulliken charges. It's a different way of calculating the charge. What Mulliken charge takes place is, suppose if you have a benzene ring, okay, so it is taken as neutral. But when you substitute in the first position, and suppose you have nitrobenzene, then the diagonal relationship is calculated. What is present here? Here H is present. Diagonally, you will see an electropositive element, electron withdrawing element here, and electron neutral element here. And then diagonally here, they will see some charges. So you might have seen Pauling's scale of electronegativity. Have you heard of that? I think probably you have heard of that. Pauling's scale of electronegativity, it calculates the difference, electronegative difference between the atoms that are substituted there. So this is one way to calculate charge. And you know the charge on the electron. What is the charge on the electron? 1.605, something like that. Okay. So there are different ways to calculate the charge of the electron, but I am just showing you a few examples that should probably inspire you to switch over to the computational chemistry. Here is the first part. I think probably you might have downloaded this. If you have a chem sketch, you will first open the template window, and you can choose any ring there. I'll choose again benzene ring, and I'll place it here. Okay, so you can click draw or you can click structure. Okay, if you click structure, I choose this one, N, and if you place here, it becomes a pyridine molecule. Okay, so again, if I click this and draw some line like this, it becomes NCS3. Look at this way, because nitrogen atom, you know, it is having nitrogen is having a valency of 3, but putting a additional methyl group there, you know, it creates a additional valency, so it gets a positive charge. Now I'm going to save this. I'm going to save this as so many formats of that. I'm going to save this as MOLP3000. It's called as a MOLP. So it is methyl pyridine. I'll just name it as a methyl pyridine. So look at this methyl pyridine that I have said here. If you open this by means of some commands that are there, I'm opening it with the notepad. You can see how it is written. All the molecules are written in a particular format. We are not bothered about this format. I'll try reopening it with some other softwares to see what we have done. Probably we have downloaded this Winmo Star. I'm invoking this Winmo Star because it is free of charge and it is able to visualize that. So here we can open this, and we can select here the mol files there. Is this the mol file? We go to the desktop, I can see. Not seeing any mol file there. Here it is, methyl pyridine. So it should be saved in mol format version 3000. Then I am again reopening it. Methyl pyridine. It's not coming there. File, save as. You just follow these steps. You can note this down in your notebook, and you can just always rework over that. Now here it is. So here there are no hydrogens there, pyridine. But if you have this, click this icon, can add hydrogen at so many places. It's wrongly added there nowadays. Now I'll just skip over this, but because this is a very complex molecule, I'm not taking this, but I'm directly going over to some example that I have done there. So you can see the Firefly there. They are telling Firefly. Firefly is the name of the software that is there. I am visualizing this molecule in a software which is also free. It is beautiful software, very beautiful software. You can see this. It's the name of that molecule is Circuline. You have 6-membered ring, and centered there is a 5-membered ring. Now this is a kind of a football's head. You have got football fullerene. That type of molecules there. On the left part, you can see the starting geometry is given, something random. There are these steps 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that it goes on. What are these steps? In these steps, the program calculates the energy, thermodynamic energy at each and every step, and puts out the energy This energy is a resultant of the core-core repulsion, core-electron attraction, electron-electron repulsion, van der Waals forces, so many forces it includes. And it finally gives the optimized geometry. Okay. Optimized geometry is this one. What is meant by optimized? See, optimized geometry means, you know, if you get some car, the car, you know, has got a speedometer which shows you up to 200. Okay. 200 up to 200 kilometers per hour you can reach it, but under what conditions? You should have zero resistance from there, you should have a very good road, you should not have any traffic. It's an optimized meter. Actually, practically speaking, you cannot go at 200. You will end up only with 100, 120, at the most you'll go at 140. You want to go for 200 is an optimized. So optimized means you can achieve it. It is the most accepted, beyond which, you know, something will fall, something will happen, something rupture will take place. So that is the optimized geometry. So they have kept all the distance at a particular things. And then if you click this, you can see the dipole moment, you know, it goes at the center. Dipole moment is at the center of the molecule. So it's a neutral molecule, therefore it is at the center point. You can have inversion center there. So I can even see the atomic properties there. The atomic properties include charges. What are the charges there? You can see the charge at each carbon atom. The charge is about -0.038. Uniformly it is for the central five-membered ring, it is -0.038. For the outer carbons, it is 0.073 and -0.01, and it changes. For the hydrogen, it is 0.1. Plus 0.1. There is no minus charge there. Here you have minus charge there. So I can change this and find out the atom electron density. The atom electron density is the valency of the carbon should be 4, but it is coming to about 4.038. Somehow it has withdrawn some electrons. How? You can see the hydrogen has got a valency of 1. Some of the electrons of this have gone into this through this. There. So that is one way of visualizing the results. Further, you can click them and you can see the NMR spectrum. This is the NMR spectrum. You don't need to buy NMR spectrum. You can directly calculate the NMR spectra there. Beautifully, the program for the aniline, say the circulin that is there, it shows NMR spectrum. TMS is here, and this is the upfield. You can see the intensities of this, and you can account for it. If you click there, you can get the coordinates there, and you can go for Gaussian and Lorentz branding. This is a mathematical treatment. You can copy the picture. You can put any molecule run the NMR spectrum. So NMR spectrum can be run by this, and you can update the values, you can change the values, and you can prepare NMR. So it is, you can have even HNMR or you can have FNMR. Because this molecule is not having FNMR, it will not show. But I'll take C13 NMR and then update the table and then show NMR spectrum. So it will show some Gaussian Browning. So broad bands it is showing. C13 NMR is a different thing. Okay. So this is one way of visualizing the results of that. And then you can color the atomic properties by charge. So you can see all those positively charged will be, sometimes it is red in color. So you have to put the range minus, you can change the range there and you can get the result. This is the charge distribution. Okay. So this is one good example of how you can calculate charges and the NMR spectrum. Now I will go to one of the molecules which I have calculated in my research. Chemcraft, is a software. You can see that at the top, you know, Chemcraft is there. This is a protein. This is a protein. Okay. And this protein is named as ornithine. It's an anti-cancer drug and it is also used for. Actually, this protein was brought to be by one particular student who was working in some pharmaceutical company. And here you can see the label type plus number, you can see carbon 1, nitrogen, oxygen, everything is numbered there. So this was actually used as a hair remover. This was actually used as a hair remover. That particular person, he was our student, MSc student. He brought this molecule and wanted to know if this has got some medicinal properties. So I took up this molecule and calculated lot of properties. This is a very good molecule. It's a protein. It's a non-essential protein. You have to supply it from, it is an essential protein. You have to supply from outside. If you supply that from outside, it just goes and attacks with some certain enzyme. That mechanism also I have. Now, this, you know, the beauty of this is I'm going to analyze the molecular orders. Look at this. This is the beauty of the of this molecule is that you can click this and have energies of the atoms in the, you have studied in the quantum chemistry, what is A, what is the symmetry, you can see that word symmetry, and you can always go where you can see occupied level and the energy connected with that. There are so many orbitals. So there is a place where you have occupied orbital and unoccupied orbital. Now I am going over to this particular place and I'm trying to visualize this. The lower part that is red, that is given in red, comprises of the valence orbitals. Okay, so they have drawn the molecular orbitals. I just click over this thing and to get the electrons. So you can see the orbital numbers are given and electron spin is also given. Electron spin is also given there. Beautiful. So far you have drawn these things, but here you are going to get the visualization of the result. Orbital 35 is having both the electrons. Orbital 36 is having both the electrons. 37 is empty. All our chemical reactions do take place at this particular place. Excitation of electron from this to this goes place. So this is the band gap. 37 to 35 is the difference. If the difference is very large, excitation is very, very, very difficult. If the distance is very small, the gap between these two is very small, quick excitation is possible. So decomposition is, you know, going of this electron into some other orbitals. Now you can customize the diagram of them. Or you can even calculate the band energy there directly. I am trying to calculate HOMO minus LUMO in electron volts. You can see it comes to about minus 5.679 electron volts, the difference between. This is a very good, it can be taken as a very good organic semiconductor, because something which is having less than 5 or less than 10 electron volts, you can just take it as a very good electron moving property, or electron, for example, where you want to have very good fluorescence and all. Quick excitation must be possible. Fire, you know, how does the fire, there's actually a plasma where electrons can jump over and quickly come back. So I think you have this diagram, you have seen this in photochemistry, you have this this thing called as S0 to T1 transition. Okay. In the Jablonski diagram. So you always draw S0 and then have S1, but simultaneously you will have T1 also. Here you will have an electron there. When you pass h nu, it goes to the place S1. It returns back by emitting a different frequency, which you call it as the Compton frequency, if you have it is less than that. But in some cases, if T1 is less than the S1, the electron excitation from this to this takes place and it gets inverted. Pauli exclusion is violated. When it gets inverted, it finds time to spend some time there. And that is a time-dependent phenomena. And then when it returns from T1 to S0, it emits out something which you called as the fluorescence quenching. Fluorescence, you might have studied in the Jablonski diagram. Okay, in the Jablonski diagram is what you are seeing here, this kind of thing. You can have triplet electrons also. I can show you triplet electrons later. But here, this is a free software. People have done so much efforts to bring out the visualized part of what we have been studying in the previous classes. So why not use it? You know, you can just use it, and then you can also use it for teaching purpose also in future also. So I'm just closing this. I'm taking over to another aspect where. Here you can see atomic properties for the NMR spectrum. There are so many things. I have calculated natural charge. So I'll just update the table and ask it to show the NMR spectrum. It is showing me a beautiful NMR spectrum. I am able to characterize this NMR spectrum also very well. Okay, NMR spectrum I am able to calculate depending on which is where and which is the chemical shape, which is the what is the chemical shape, higher or lower chemical shape. Okay, so if I change the, I'm just taking natural charge. If I take Mulliken charge, I update the table, I'll get a slightly different spectrum because charge calculation parameters are different for natural charge and the Mulliken charges. Then I can have total valence also. If I'm just taking the valence electron, the spectrum is different. It is to be kept in mind that not all valence electrons go for reactivity. If you have a valence electron for carbon for 4, all the 4 reactants go into the bonding. But in your organic lab during the preparation, only a few get broken. Not all the carbon atoms are broken, only a few where there is electronegativity or electropositivity or electrophilicity difference. That bonds break and you bring the reactivity at that part. So whatever type of charge you calculate, you can just click the tools and and you can also have the color charge. Natural charge color is like that. C15 is having red charge. C11, I mean the border is red to blue. Blue is positive, red is negative. Suppose if you substitute one fluorine atom, it's an electronegative atom, it will have more electron charges, and therefore you will get a very good red thing. Okay. Now this is the MO energy diagram, and then I'll try to show you this graph also where SCF self-constant field convergence is there. It started with so much high energy, moved the bonds, moved the bond angles, and moved the dihedral angles to minimize the electrostatic repulsion and so many other forces. Slowly reduced the energy, and you can see the table. It was started with 1.32 energy in the angstrom minute. It has come to zero. So that is the stable form of that. Okay. Now I'll just try to render a molecular orbital. I'll take up this occupied molecular orbital, and you can see the molecular orbital occupied. This is the last one, 36. 37 is unoccupied. I'll just click over it. And it is trying to calculate and show me the occupied orbital is just like this. I just show both signs, isosurfaces. I will just show this. How the lobes are different. Okay. You can see that the COOH part is here. COOH part is there. There are no orbitals, highest occupied molecular orbitals. Highest occupied molecular orbitals are not present in carbon 15, oxygen 16 and 17. Therefore, after optimizing a molecule, you can suggest that the reactivity of this protein is not due to this. It is due to this, NH2, CH, CH, CH2. Why? Because there are these orbitals there. These orbitals, suppose if I want to work, you know, I need to have some table space where I can write and put and mouse and those things. That space is what you call it there, the orbitals. When there is no space, you cannot have electron freedom. You cannot have playing of the electrons so that they can interact with the other things and get into the reactivity. So this is a picture. I can just change the display also. look at this, it is showing the orbital very beautifully there. So the end part, you know, COOH is there at some other place. Here you have COOH. I can just label the atoms, then these are the spins of T. COOH, you know, it doesn't provide any orbital, but it has provided some reactivity due to COOH. For this molecule, highest occupied orbitals are present there. So whatever your reactions are there, they can be at this particular point. So you can just get an idea. If somebody gives you a molecule and asks you where highest occupied molecular orbital is, you can just run a program and say, this is the place where orbitals are there. And you can also just go over to the unoccupied molecular orbitals. So unoccupied, you know, highest unoccupied molecular orbitals, you know, this is the required region. Entire chemistry is in this only. Okay. So we always talk about we have a ground state and you have an excited state. If you have some electrons there, the electron, you know, it should be excited to some excited state by means of some energy, right? Unless the electron goes here to the excited state, no reactivity is there. What do we do in chemistry? We look two things: reactivity, stability. Yavala reactive, yavala stable. So for a reactivity, it has to go from ground state to the excited state. Ground state and excited state are just general terms. And in molecular orbital theory, you call this as the HOMO to LUMO, highest occupied molecular orbital. This is LU for lowest unoccupied. Right? So you have to excite this electron to this particular place. And this particular place should be a good table. Okay. So I have books in my cupboard. What is the use of those books in the cupboard? I have to take it, place it on a table, open it, have a separate place for writing. Okay. The more bigger the table I have, the more functionality my increases. I'm able to place the tab here. I'm able to place mouse here, book here, the screen there, fan there. So very good working condition I am having. But if you are asking me to stand on a wall, how can I impart my duties, you know, by writing and by clicking and those things. So I need to have very good space. Okay. That space is what you have here. Lot of space is there. You can see. And not only in that space is there, in that space you are having plus charge and minus charge also. Okay. The red or this orange portion is full of negative. So negative charge irukkira edathila Na2 plus alone na easy appo. Minus charge irukkira edathila NH2, OCH3, CN minus, idella ange react avum. So you can see that lowest unoccupied molecular orbital is a place where it can accommodate electrophiles and also the nucleophiles. At some places, you can see that in the previous HOMO case, no orbital is present in the COOH. Highest occupied orbital, no orbital in the COOH. But when you click this, so many orbitals come into the COOH. That is why the reactivity of COOH is greater than. You've got two functional groups there. One is the amino group here, NH2. The other one is the COOH group there. So amino group is having HOMO. Carboxyl group is having LUMO. So if somebody asks you, it will be reactive. You can say that LUMO is present on the carboxyl group. Therefore, carboxyl group is more reactive. Because LUMO is a place where all electrons go, all electrons react. It's a place, it's a work table. And it provides so many orbitals for electronic decoupling, for electronic inversion, for electronic mixing, Fermi levels, all those things are only this. So this visualization is able to give you a clear picture of any molecule. So you can try any molecule calculate the homologous orbital and then come back to this, find out the result there. So this is showing the outermost electrostatic potential, MESP charges which I have been telling. Here red part means now highly negative, blue part means highly electropositive. Between red and blue you have green, so you have, you can have the screen also there. I think so here this is it. This is minus, here it is shown as a minus 0.02. It is shown as plus 0.0. You can change this also, values range you are allowed to change. I usually take red as minus and blue as plus, but here it is taking in the reverse direction, so it depends. So blue means high minus, red means it is highly plus. So this is the scale there. So green comes in between. So this part is having and the unoccupied part, this part is having middle charges. But when I shift to occupied level, it is completely changing. So this surface is called as the molecular electrostatic potential. The influence of every electronic atom, electronic influence to a particular distance scale. Okay, you can save this image and you can have very good visualization later. And I can keep this surface, I can clear that all, I'll get back the atoms, and then I can do so many things, adding up and summing up the orbitals, multiplying, distracting the orbitals. That is in the higher chemistry. So I'll end with this. Is because you have calculated so many other molecules, but just again I am repeating, you can install ChemSketch. Okay, you can install ChemSketch, save it as a mol file. Here it is. The mol file can be run in the MOPAC. The results are generated. You get optimized geometry, and then you can download the game. Is the manual is there? I can have a separate session where you can run the. Where you can run the GANs program, and the out file result can be used to visualize so many electronic orbitals, NMR spectra, molecular electrostatic potential, and all those things. So it's a very, very useful thing. I'll stop share, and end the recording.